and welcome to our daily devotional program, A Light for the Nation. My name is Emmanuel Odu. Now, severally, we have been told that life can be rough. You have obstacles in life. And we're also being told in the Holy Book, the Bible, how we can break through these obstacles. Today, we are going to identify three things that can destroy your life and how you can overcome them. Now, to guide us in our reflections is Reverend Father Micheal Obi.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Come, O Holy Spirit, fill the hearts of your faithful, and enkindle in them the fire of your love. Send forth your spirit, and they shall be created, and you shall renew the face of the earth. O God, who by the light of the Holy Spirit did instruct the heart of your faithful, grant that by the same Holy Spirit we may be truly wise and ever rejoice in his consolation through Christ our Lord. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Dear viewers, you must have watched and see beautiful edifices in the world. Man takes his time to build and to build and to build. In the days of old, the people of Babel spent their energy building the Tower of Babel, and eventually it was destroyed, and languages were given to them. It is not easy to build. Today you will see wonderful nations, wonderful cities emerging from left-right corner due to the work of science and technology. Great men now build. Yes, following the injunction of what God told us, man increased, multiplied, and conquered the earth. Man is actually conquering the earth. So it is wonderful to build. But then it is very, very easy to destroy. That is one thing I want you to know. You exert more energy in building, but if you want to destroy it, it takes less energy to destroy. To destroy it is very easy. But to build, it takes a great number of energy and enormous time and energy are all exerted. So children of God, today I want us to look at the three things that could possibly destroy a man. You have been hearing of how people are destroying things, buildings, hearing one thing or the other, but also these three things can destroy a man. The three things are, one, anger. Anger can destroy a man. No wonder Jesus, our Lord Jesus Christ, said, if you are angry with your brother, you will stand before the judges. If you say your brother a raka, you will stand before the elders. And if you say you fool, you stand in danger of going to hellfire. You should be mindful of what you say to your brother. In a summary, that's what Jesus is telling us. Anger. Be careful. Don't be angry. If you do that, you will fall, you will commit, you will destroy yourself. Anger. Very small, but can destroy a man. With anger, one could go ablaze and destroy nations. With anger, one could take life. With provocation, that will lead into anger, one could be angry and do terrible things. That little thing called anger is one of the sins, the seven capital sins, that you talk of pride, covetousness, lust, anger, gluttony, envy, and sloth. Anger is one of those ones. Very small, but if it is not well controlled, it could destroy the man. We must control our anger. The Lord Jesus Christ went on to emphasize on that and even demonstrated in his life that we must not be angry. Remember, he was slapped by an ordinary slave. The slave of Pontius Pilate, he was very calm. He was not provoked. He never put into action. He was not angry. He was calm. Rather, he said, what do I do to you that you hit me? And then he also was despised. His colleagues ran away. They ran away. They abandoned him. But he was not angry. The Lord Jesus Christ was able to control himself. He controlled himself. Though some say he was angry when he flogged people in the temple, no. He was trying to tell us the zeal of the love he has for the father, for his father's house. That was what made him to use the whip against those who were buying and selling. Control your anger. If you control your anger, you are truly a man. If you are able to control your anger, yes, you are truly a man. You are a dignified man. You are a dignified building. The great building and edifice God kept in this world to sanctify other things in the world. So control your anger. Secondly, there's another thing that can destroy a man, pride. It is said pride goes before a fall. Let us be careful. Pride goes before a fall. Many kings, many heroes, many leaders have destroyed themselves because of pride. Why? Because they believe that they can control the world. They believe that they can control nations. They believe that they are heroes of life. But eventually, they fall prey. Pride. It is said pride goes before a fall. Dear children of God, be mindful of what you have. Don't allow pride to rule you. Pride goes before a fall. The Bible keeps on emphasizing on that. Be humble. The opposite of pride is humility. Let us be humble. If you have humility, you'll be able to build up. Your dignity will be restored. Pride is dangerous. Remember Pharaoh of Egypt? His pride ended when he saw the whole of his army being consumed by the Red Sea. Remember Herod, who fell down and then was converted into worm. He experienced decay because his people saw it and they heard his voice and say, oh, it was resounding like the voice of a god. Oh, children of God, great men has fallen. What about Goliath and the rest? Great men has fallen in the history of salvation, even in the history of life. Be careful, oh man. Don't allow pride to rule you. What about Lucifer, the first creature of God in heaven, who fell down from heaven? He was thrown down from heaven, Revelation 12:12. Pride goes before a fall. Let us be careful. Another thing that can destroy a man is unforgiveness. Yes, Jesus said that in the scripture, that if you are about to offer your gift at the altar, and then you remember that you have something against your brother, or your brother has something against you, leave it there and go first, be reconciled with your brother. And in teaching us the Lord's Prayer, it came to that aspect where we said, forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who trespass against us. But then the Lord Jesus emphasized by saying, if you do not forgive your brother his trespasses or his sins, your heavenly Father will not forgive yours too. So dear children of God, we should learn how to forgive. Wipe off everything like that has to do with unforgiveness in your conscience. If you have a clear conscience, you live a happy life. And you build up your spirit in all ramifications. Dear children of God, these three things can destroy the man. Anger, pride, and unforgiveness. Don't be angry, avoid pride, and try to forgive. And then you'll be great. You build yourself, your dignity will be restored, and you see God our Father will be pleased with you. Dear viewers, as you go today, practice the three. Anger, do not practice it. Anger, go into brotherly love. Pride, go into humility. Unforgiveness, go into love. Let us pray. God our Father, you have given us this word of life. Help us to live them so that at the end we'll sanctify the world through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you and with your spirit. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Reverend Father Micheal Obi is of the Catholic Diocese of Ogoja in Cross River State, letting us into some of the obstacles you can face in life, some of the things that can destroy you. So you now know some of these things that can destroy your life, your spiritual life, your physical life. You have to watch out for those things. And I believe the other advice is to pray so that God can give you the strength and the guidance to go through these obstacles in life. Spread the word as you have heard it. Now, if you have any questions or suggestions, then send us a short message to the numbers you find on the screen. Or send us a mail to ctvnigeria@yahoo.com. ctvnigeria is one word, @yahoo.com. Or post your comments on our Facebook. We'd love to read from you. It's another lovely day. Go out and enjoy it and spread the word amongst your friends. Have a lovely and happy day. Bye now. Faultless womb, ye in Jesus was laid, that light has come.